Hi guys, Kirk and Jay here with Kirk, Giordano Plastering. Today, this is going to be our last opportunity to show this home here, which we applied a BMI, reinforced fiber cement plaster to. I wanted to point out some things. Product number one is a remarkable modern product. It's great. Here, we've given the house at least a month to cure. How long does BMI say that the base coat should cure? 7 to 10 days. We're way over because I want to make sure that there's no hairline cracking coming before we do our color finish next week. Anyway, I wanted to point something out. What causes cracking, guys? Vibration, movement. That's what causes cracking. Say like this door. It's a steel reinforced door because this is a school. You see that? I mean, that is a lot of vibration. Every door in the country, if it's this heavy, we'll have hairline cracks going up and down the stucco at angles. But we don't have any here. It's nice, but it's makes me wonder, wow, this is such a great product. Of course, we put two expansion joints, but even then, I still should have some horizontals, which we generally do with traditional Portland cement. So again, this BMI product, I'm throwing it a bone because, man, I'm impressed. I actually did a BMI home last year, about the equivalent of this, and we didn't have any product, no problems. I kept calling the fella saying, gee, any cracks? Because the first time I used it on a whole house this size. This is the second time on a whole house this size. Anyway, I was calling the fella. Let me get off that train of thought. No cracks. We should have them right here. I was calling the fella last year saying, gee, any cracks? For a month, none, Kirk. And I thought, wow, excellent. Then 3 months later, he called me back and says, hey, we got some cracks. And it turns out he did the sheetrock afterwards. He put a bunch of structural beams, removed a couple decks that were attached to the house, 10 times better than this one. You can't do that, guys. You cannot do that. We're going to walk around here, and I'll show you some other things. Like this wall here, no windows. So we popped a couple expansion joints. Same on the inside because there's no windows. Windows, doors. You don't need the expansion joints because they create their own. Inside here, I want to point out something too, guys. All right. Now, generally, we should have some cracks going here because we've hydrated inside here too. Yeah, I took a water hose and drenched this for a couple days, and Jay did the same. We should have them. We don't. Can they happen? Yes. They got to remove all the staging up above my head, and that's going to lift it. We can get 5 months of solid rain, which can lift the ground and settle that ground. Yes, we can still get some. Generally, I'm going to do my color finish next week, so if I see them, I was going to put some fiber mesh tape and just go over it. That reassures so they don't come back. But even so, if you're on earthquakes areas, and yeah, I've done houses in earthquake zones, they will reoccur. But on this particular one, I'm noticing the cracks here. We got some massive cracks here. And this was, it was disturbing because I thought, oh crap, we're going to get some serious cracks on this outside wall or these walls, but it hasn't. If 6 to 8 inches has cracked like this, then that's just the tip of the iceberg for the one back here. It's also cracked. I thought for sure these are going to crack. We don't have any cracks, and I'll tell you another thing. The deck here, I told the contractor, he says, well, gee, Kirk, can you get started? I want to get the scaffold out of here. And I said, I could get started and we can get that scaffold out of here. However, I'd prefer you to finish that deck. Now, that's a pretty massive deck right here going up. And when you attach that deck, that's movement, vibration. If they put a tractor, no, I can't get a tractor back here, but when they get rid of all this dirt, it's movement, it's replacement of soil. 30 days of rain, let alone 6 months, it's going to lift and expand this. So that's stuff to look out for. Now, say this. While we're at it, man, I figure I'll point this out. We got a big crack right here, and it's right underneath this scaffold leg. Now, how about that? Is it coincidental? No. This leg is going up, and look how heavy it is. It's you're talking 20 feet. There's tons and tons right here. That is what caused that crack. So if you guys have hot tubs, roofs, get them on there. Get the sheetrock up before fellows like me come and do the stucco work. Otherwise, you're going to have massive cracks. The only thing they got left here is they're going to bring in furniture. That won't do it. Tape and mud won't do it, although the inside is completely finished now. So I wanted to point that out because I called my buddy Rui, who's the president of BMI, and it says, hey, Rui, we've got an issue. He says, oh, crap, what's going on? I said, well, the house hasn't even hairlined yet, and I don't trust a house that doesn't hairline, just like I don't trust a man that don't drink. And he says, well, I got a sledgehammer in my truck. I can come and help you out if you like. And I thought, well, that's not necessary, but thank you anyway. But what I'm really trying to show you folks, because this is going to be covered up next week, is a sensational new modern product. BMI 690. Man, it's a great product. If I do homes like this, which I still will, I've got at least 10 years left in me, I think, I'm always going to have the silo delivered and just use this product because it's less hassle for me. It costs me a lot less in material and labor. I don't have to have all the my own mixers out there. And you get a perfect mix every time, and it's structurally stronger with the fibers, and it's actually water resistant too. So I'm throwing a bone to BMI. That product is absolutely amazing. So try it, you contractors, homeowners. If you have contractors working for you, hey, call them up and say, man, get me a silo out here and get that 690 reinforced fibered mesh, because it's awesome stuff. I'm amazed. Anyhow, my name is Kirk, Jason on the camera. We thank you for watching, and as usual, we'll see you guys on the next one. Once again, folks, we thank you for watching, and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below. And also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching, and from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.